Hi and welcome. In this video, we are going to see about number of ways question, okay, from prime time. So the question says that you are given an integer n and there are two sets A and B. Both sets contain n distinct objects. Fine. Now we have to choose at least one object from these sets. Now it is at least one. Fine. That means we can choose 2, 3, 4, 5 n objects. Okay. It is at least one. So how the selection can be done? We can choose zero object from set 1, set A, and we can choose one object from set B, or we can choose one object from set A and zero object from set B, or we can choose one object from set A or one object from set B, or means two objects can be chosen, correct? At least one is there. Or we can choose zero object from set A and two objects from set B, zero object from set A, three objects from set B, zero object from set A, n objects from set B. Similarly, here also one object from two objects from set A, zero object from set B, and it so goes on. There are many ways. Fine. So we need to know this number of ways. What are the total number of ways? And we need, since the answer can be very large, we can mod it with 10 to the power of 9 plus 7. Fine. So for example, this is the sample test case given to us. So we can see here that if n value is 1, that means in A and B we have one object and n value is 1. So what are the choices? We can select 0 object from set A and 1 object from set B. We can select 1 object from set A and 0 object from set B. We can select 1 object from set A and 1 object from set B. Fine, these are my choices. Okay, now in mathematically in NC format it is also given that how we can write this. Okay, so we can simply write this as we can selecting 0 object from set A multiplied by selecting 1 object from set B. Okay, or we can select 1 object from set A and 0 object from set B. Correct, or we can select 1 object from set A and 1 object from set B. So this becomes 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is nothing but there are 3 ways. Fine. Now how to solve this particular question? So as we can see, for each 0, means here if we have a 0, we can have 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, 6, correct? Then we select one object from set A, we can select 0 object from set B, 1 object from set B, 2 object from set B, 3 object from set B, 4, 1 object from set A. So it is actually like this. We are selecting, let's say, 0 object from set A, okay? So now we have a choice of selecting one object from set B. We do not have a choice of selecting 0 object from set B if we are selecting 0 object from set A, correct? Because we need to select at least one object. Or we can also write that for 0 object from set A, we also have a choice of selecting 2 objects from set B. Or we can also write that from 0 objects from set A, there is 3 objects from set B, and so on. For 0 objects from set A, we can select all the n objects that are present in set B, correct? This can be done. Now similarly, this can be done. Similarly, what can be done? One object from set A and 0 object from set B, or one object from set A and 1 object from set B, or one object from set A and 2 object from set B, and so on. One object from set A and n object from set B, or we can also write NC2, that is 2 object from set A and 0 object from set B, 2 objects from set A and 1 object from set B, and this goes on here also and here also. That is still n object from set A and set A and 0 object from set B, n object from set A and 1 object from set B, and so on, n object from set A and n object from set B. These are my all choices in this particular question. Fine. So how we can write this? So we can write this as 0 object from set A, and just take NC0 as common and rest we can simply add, correct? Just taking NC0 as common, we can simply add the rest of them, NC4 till NCN. Similarly, we can take NC1 as common, that is one object from set A, and rest we can simply add, that is just taking common from our above equations, we are taking common. Similarly, NC2, NC0 plus NC1 plus NC2 and so on till NCN. And this also goes on till NCN. NC0 plus NC1 plus NC2, so on. Fine. Now, see this NC0, NC1, NC2, NC0, NC1, NC2, NC0, NC1, NC2. These could have been taken common if this was also NC0 was also present here. Means now also it can, but it will only be to this point. This will remain. Fine. Now, if also we have NC0 here, then we can take the whole thing as common. Correct. So what we can do is we can add a NC0 here, and simultaneously we'll subtract NC0 multiplied by NC0 from the whole equation so that it does not change anything. What do I mean by that is just simply have NC0 and also have NC0 here. Fine, NC1 and rest of the things is same as we have already seen. Fine. In the end, have my subtract an NC0 multiplied by NC0. Subtract this. So when NC0 multiplied by NC0, this term arrives. This is subtracted here. Our equation remains the same. Fine. It is nothing but plus and minus the same thing, so that the equation remains the same. Okay. But it is really affecting our, it is actually simplifying our whole equation. Now what we can do is, since we have an NC0 here, we can take the whole thing as common. Correct. And if we take the whole inner bracket as common, the outer brackets, what will happen to outer brackets? So it will be something like NC0 plus NC1 plus NC2 plus NC3 and so on till NCn multiplied by NC0 plus NC1 plus NC2 till NCn minus NC0 multiplied by NC0. What happened here? So it is nothing but this bracket is taken as common, this one. Fine. Now, since this bracket is taken as common, we have NC0, NC1, NC2, NC3, NC4, NCn outside. So that bracket is this. Fine. So we have these two brackets minus NC0 into NC0, which is nothing but 1. So this can be written as a 1. Fine. Now, what we can do about these brackets? So there is a direct property that we can use here. Okay. So how that property came is using binomial expansion. Fine. If you know the direct property, you can directly use it. Okay, so of 1 plus x to the power of n, fine. So this can here, this 1 plus x to the power of n can be written as NC0 plus NC1x plus NC2x square plus NC3x cube and so on till NCn x to the power of n. Fine. In this whole equation, in this equation, what we have is the x value is not present. X value, if we have x value as 1, so 1 square is 1, 1 cube is 1, 1 to the power of n is 1. So if we just substitute x equals to 1 in the above equation, we get 1 plus 1 to the power of n is nothing but NC0 plus NC1 plus NC2 and so on till NCn. So this becomes nothing but 2 to the power of n. So this whole line can be substituted as 2 to the power of n. This whole line can be substituted as 2 to the power of n. Fine. So we can simply write this as 2 to the power of n multiplied by 2 to the power of n minus 1. Why minus 1? Because of this. So 2 to the power of n multiplied by 2 to the power of n minus 1. Fine. This here can simply be written as 2 to the power of 2n minus 1. This is the number of ways we can get our answer. Fine. Now calculating this is simple, but obviously since our answer can go very long, we need to calculate the power using mode, not a direct power. Okay, 2 to the power of 2 into n, but using mod. Remember that. Fine. Mod is needed here because the answer can go very big. Fine. So there is nothing in the implementation. I will just show you the implementation now. Okay, because till here it's fine. I have explained how we got this equation. Now this equation is our final answer. We'll take n as input, we'll call our power function to calculate this, and we get the final answer using mode. Fine. So this was the logic of this particular question. Okay, let's look at the implementation now. Okay, so we are taking t as the input, then we are running a test case loop. After that we are taking n as the input. Fine. Now we just need to calculate 2 to the power of 2n, subtract it by minus 1, and we get our answer. Fine. So the power function here needs to work with mod. So therefore it is working with mod now. Result equals to, now this whole is nothing but no power function, but with mod of 10 to the power of 9 plus 7. Fine. Finally we are returning our result and we are printing it. Fine. So this is the implementation for this particular question. Okay, power function using mod and nothing else. We just need to know that we need to use this. Okay. and it's very straightforward. Fine. Thank you.